This video is brought to you by Yubico. Hey guys, Max here, and in this video, I want to go over some tips that I have for first-time Android users who may have just switched from iOS to make the switch as seamless as possible, and the sorts of stuff that I would have loved to know when I made the switch a couple days ago. All right, I'm gonna try to get through this as quickly as possible. So my first tip is in the setup process or afterwards, either one, you want to transfer the files and the photos and the contacts and everything from your iPhone onto your Android phone. And a lot of Android phones have apps built in like OnePlus Switch that are able to transfer data from your iPhone to your Android super seamlessly after you've set it up. But there's an option in your setup process where you're able to choose to do that. And so I definitely recommend that you do that because that saves the hassle of number one, doing it later, and also makes it a much more seamless experience where you can deal with figuring out how Android works and stuff like that rather than having to deal with, like, you know, the sorts of stuff like bring your photos or contacts in via Gmail or anything like that. Just do it all in the setup and it's going to make it a lot easier for you. So one of the things that I'm kind of learned throughout this process is that you need to switch iMessage off after you have switched to Android and after you've put your SIM card in your Android phone, because what ends up happening is that there are messages that you might miss that go to your iPhone, which can be super irritating, and you're missing a lot of messages just because you're not using that phone anymore. So in settings, you need to scroll down to messages and you need to press off iMessage so that you don't get iMessage onto your phone anymore, and now it's just onto your Android phone, because that's going to make it a lot easier for you to actually get messages. If you're carrying both phones at the same time like I am, it's probably not a massive deal, but I would definitely recommend doing that for people who are going to be like moving away from Apple maybe for your iMessage. So you're going to want to turn that off immediately, and that's one of the best things that you need to do when you're switching to Android. This next tip is a little bit of like a techie tip. So if you buy an Android phone with a high refresh rate and a high resolution, I recommend switching that on, because it's a lot more fun if you have your 120Hz or 90Hz and your Quad HD Plus or your Full HD Plus turned on. And so you're going to want to bump up to that in your settings of whatever, you know, phone you're using. If you want to go into display, and then you can press advanced, and in there is all of your display settings and stuff. You want to turn that right up. It won't let your battery last as long, but for most light users, it's going to be totally fine. It's going to give you a better experience on your new Android phone, which is super fun. So that's one of the first things that I did when I turned my device off. So the next thing is learn the gestures and kind of move around on your device a little bit. So there's stuff like swiping up from the bottom, which can bring you back to your homepage, or anywhere on Android, you can swipe down from the top and it brings down your notification shade. Then you swipe down one more time and it gives you all of your advanced settings for your sort of control center type activities in your Android phone. And so, you know, that's the iOS equivalent of that, but it's super easy to do that. All you have to do is just have to swipe down twice and then you have all of your settings right there, right in front of you. And so it's a pretty convenient way to do that, and I really do like that. It's made it a lot easier for me going around Android, because it's a lot more familiar for me because I'm an iOS user. So the next thing is moving around in settings to customize a couple of the things that you might want to do. And so you can customize your font, you can customize your accent color, which I did as well, changed to blue. Blue is my favorite color. And so there's a lot of customization you can do in Android. And so it's really fun to be able to do that and take advantage of that. It's a fun feature to have and it's a fun thing to be able to do. And so I think that taking advantage of that and, you know, figuring out what you'd really like in your phone is one of the most fun things about Android, at least for me who has just switched from iPhone. My last tip may seem a little bit obvious, but that's to sign into all of your accounts. And so one of the things that I suggest you doing before you switch to Android is you buy one of the YubiKeys by Yubico. The YubiKey by Yubico is the leading two-factor authentication security key. It's extremely secure, durable, easy to use, and portable, adding an extra layer of security to your brand new Android device or any device you have in your arsenal. The YubiKey has been an instrumental part of my switch to Android, and I'm not just saying that because they're my sponsor. I genuinely wish I had a YubiKey in so many online experiences in the past, and chances are, if you're watching this, you've had a password or account compromised, even if you didn't know it. They're also so easy to set up. With two-factor authentication options on so many websites nowadays, the security key becomes your key to unlock all of your important accounts on all of your favorite websites or apps, just like Gmail, Twitter, Xbox, YouTube, LastPass, and Instagram, and so, so many more. They've helped me, and maybe they could help you too. Check out my link below or use the coupon code YubiKeySave5 at checkout for $5 off any order right up front. Thanks again to Yubico, the maker of the YubiKey, for sponsoring this video, and thank you for supporting the channel. So that's it. That's some of the stuff that I would have loved to know when I actually switched to Android a few days ago, and I hope that it could help some people who are contemplating the switch as well out there somewhere in the world watching this video. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.